Tonight, could Tony Windsor's return bring down the Deputy Prime Minister, Barnaby Joyce? There's a new miracle fat drug in town, so will this one finally give us the obesity cure we've been looking for? Think your kids know where fruit comes from? Well, you might want to ask them, just to be sure. And television legend Alan Alder joins us for a fascinating chat. That and the day's top news stories, this is The Project.
Good evening, welcome to The Project, coming to you live once more from the wonderful Adelaide Oval. Have a look at that, that's the Tailfeather Plaza. That's where we are. You can see behind us, right there. We're back with us tonight, proud Adelaidean, Pete.
The Honourable Christopher Pye!
It is. Thank you. Wonderful to have you here. Before we get going, I just need to, before we get into the headlines, there's just been some breaking news. Reuters have just reported that the election will officially be held on July 2.
I don't believe you, Waleed.
You really don't believe
I don't believe you, no.
Are you calling Reuters a liar?
I just spoke to the Prime Minister. He just rang me up while I was on the set.
Yeah. Was that who you were talking
to? He did not. That's who I was talking to.
He didn't tell you.
Did you keep a note?
Does that mean you're out of the loop now? He's not telling you these
important things? He would tell me for sure.
All right, tell us.
Otherwise, it's over.
Just tell him.
The second half of the year, Waleed.
For God's sake. July 2 is the second half of the year.
What?
Did he tell you not to stuff it up? Did he tell you? Time now to see what's making news this Thursday, the 10th of March, in a horror crash involving two golf buggies on Queensland's Hamilton Island has left 8 people injured, including a 9-month-old baby girl. She's fighting for life in Townsville Hospital. A 30-year-old woman believed to be her mother was also airlifted to Townsville with critical injuries. The remaining 550 workers at Clive Palmer's Townsville nickel refinery have today been told come tomorrow at 5 p.m. they will be out of a job. Administrators say they had no choice but to sack them because the new Clive Palmer company that's taken over the refinery is yet to hire any staff. And it seems there are a lot of Aussie kids who could do with a visit to a farm because they've got no idea where food comes from. New research has found 1 in 5 kids don't know that fruit grows on trees, while 1/4 don't know that butter comes from cow's milk.
It's quite obvious where it comes from. Foodland. I mean, that's... Moving on from that awkward discussion, we are here in Adelaide, the festival city, and we've had a great time. But today, AFL CEO Gil McLachlan was spruiking Victoria as the capital of sport.
And what today's discussion is about investment in sports infrastructure in this town, so Victoria continues to be the major events and sports capital of Victoria.
Victoria is the capital event sport of Victoria?
Yes.
He's not aiming very high.
I was going to claim him as a South Australian until I realised you'd made that gaffe today. Yeah. Gillen is from South Australia.
Is that one of your jobs in tonight's show? Just point out all the South Australian things?
Start to mention my donors.
Welcome to election year, everyone.
Well, speaking of politics, the worst kept secret in politics is officially out of the bag today, with retired MP Tony Windsor planning to unretire and contest his old seat against Barnaby Joyce.
Previously on Barnaby's Choice. After revealing his dark side by threatening to kill Captain Jack's dogs, Barnaby was rewarded with the Deputy Prime Ministership, only to learn his arch-enemy Tony Windsor has returned from the grave.
Next week on Barnaby's Choice, Captain Jack's dogs have a thirst for revenge.
How damaging is this going to be for the government? I mean, the possibility of losing a deputy PM?
Well, I don't think sequels ever work, Carrie. You know, Funny Girl was good, but Funny Lady never made it in the box office. And
just answer the question.
And I don't think Tony Windsor's comeback will be successful. See, he left in 2013 because he was going to lose. He can't deliver, so I think the people won't vote for him.
Godfather Part 2, Empire Strikes Back, reasonable sequels. But anyway,
never as good as the original.
Have you had a chance to speak to the Prime Minister about this today?
I saw the Prime Minister all day today because he was in Adelaide and I was with him all day.
So you addressed it today?
No, we didn't discuss it.
Did you have other things to discuss?
We discussed lots of things.
Let's see some of those things you discussed on an escalator today.
I'm looking forward to your speech.
Good, me too. I've put a lot of effort into it.
You always do.
Good, yeah. Let's see how it goes.
Just natural conversation, just flowing. I can't wait to see the sequel when you go back down the escalator.
It's true. I should have thought of something beforehand to say. Never mind.
All right, we'll come back and grill you later on some other stuff. We're going to go to a break right now. See you soon.
Coming up, guess who flew a chopper around the Barossa today. Oh, right, you can see it was Pete. Damn. And is this the new miracle fat drug we've been searching for? This is The Project. Take it home, girl, come on, take it home.
Welcome back to The Project.
Well done. Some more news now, and Sam Frost left Richie Strawn heartbroken when she sent him home from The Bachelorette last year after he made it to the final three. Well, good news. Richie's got another shot at finding true love. He's been confirmed as this year's Bachelor. Cool bananas. And some West Virginian politicians who recently succeeded in overturning a law banning raw milk have all become sick after drinking the stuff to celebrate their victory. Health experts warn that raw, unpasteurised milk can contain dangerous bacteria, but the sick pollies are still denying the drink is responsible for their symptoms.
So in other words, Christopher, the milkshake brings all the vomit to the yard.
That's nice. We've been out and about a lot. Carrie and I went to Clipsal.
We've had a very good bonding week, haven't we?
Yeah, we have. Yeah. You weren't there.
Today I did go to the Barossa Valley.
Wow, and, where was our invite?
No, I prefer to drink alone. but I started by getting my Bronwyn Bishop on. Check me out. Look at my go. Yeah, that's a heli. That's a helicopter. That's a helicopter right there. Off we go. Great day. Barossa is a beautiful part of the world.
Now, it's time for us to go to a break, but before we do, we want to remember John English, an Aussie rock icon gone too soon.
In 1972, John English burst onto the Aussie showbiz scene. Over five decades, his success spanned the stage, screen and songwriting. This morning, a statement confirmed the 66-year-old music legend died overnight from complications after surgery.
Delivered differently. The Project on 10.
Welcome back. This is The Project coming to you live from the Adelaide Oval right across that river there. And, it's been wonderful to be here all week.
Some more news now, and a staunch pro-gun activist has been seriously injured when she was accidentally shot by her four-year-old son as they drove along a Florida highway. She could now be charged for not securing the gun properly.
Hey, now one thing I've noticed about coming to Adelaide all these years is that they actually speak properly here. It's quite weird. It really is. In fact, it's almost un-Australian. and it's got me wondering, what the hell are you? There's something a little different about the way Crow Eaters speak. And I'm not just talking about Stobie poles, pie floaters, fruit chocks, iced coffees and frits, although I'm quite hungry. I'm talking about the South Australian accent. Now, there are a few major theories as to why South Australians sound different. Theory one. Most Aussie capital cities started out as convict colonies, full of Irish and working class types. Adelaide wasn't. Theory two. In the 48 years between the First Fleet and the founding of Adelaide, the English accent itself actually evolved. Theory three is much simpler. South Australians just like being different.
So, Christopher, can you tell me the secret to your magnificent accent?
Well, the best thing might be to have a practice run. So why don't you try and say, would you like a glass of fine Barossa white wine?
Would you like a glass of fine Barossa white wine?
You might be just sort of extending out the wine at the end.
And the white wine?
Got to be clipped. White wine.
Wine.
That's
white,
better.
White
yeah.
wine.
Much better. Yeah, yeah.
With Christopher Payne.
Coming up, the incredible cravings that make some pregnant women want to eat washing powder and even dirt. Borny's out of the jungle, so how long before he calls Carmen Electra? And the legendary star of MASH, Alan Alda, joins us for a chat. You're watching The Project.
In South Africa, where the celebrities are no doubt feeling a little lonely after last night's shock departure of camp favourite Shane Warne. Well, the man himself, Warney, joined us earlier.
Hey guys, how are you?
Very well. Not as good as you, I imagine, getting out of that jungle. I mean, that bloody big spider you had to hold. Let's talk about that for a moment. That was a moment, I reckon, of the show I will never forget watching that.
Yeah, I enjoyed myself. The spider was obviously went to hell and back. And look, a phobia is a real thing. There's a lot of difference between people saying, I hate snakes or I hate spiders or I really don't like them, I'm scared of them. Look, that was something that was pretty tough.
Now, Warnie, we do have to talk about the issue of your charity because, of course, you and Fev were going to donate money to that charity. There's been the audit. You're about to land back in Australia and land right in the middle of that issue. What are you doing about that the moment you get back home?
What I can say about the Shane Warne Foundation, when I went on a trip of a lifetime with Challenge Kids with Cancer to America, we took 10 children that were in remission, and I saw what financial money and support to seriously ill and underprivileged children can do. And for that, we're very, very proud of. If people want to have a crack at us for raising money and making a difference, go ahead and do it. We've got absolutely nothing to hide. You can all get stuffed if you want to have a go at us for it, but we're very, very proud of what we've been able to achieve.
Oh, well, I'm not sure the independent auditors will go and get stuffed, but I suppose we'll see what they ultimately say. Warnie, in the meantime...
They do what they want.
We'll ultimately see. In the meantime, congratulations on making it this far.
You're doubting me, mate. You think we've got something to hide?
No, I'm not saying anything, but I'm not an auditor. So I've got absolutely no comment on
okay.
it. Beyond that, congratulations on making it this far.
Absolutely, my pleasure, and thanks very much for everyone's support out there. It meant a lot.
I mean, look, who knows what's actually going on? The audit will find out. You can understand that someone who's poured their heart and soul into something would get defensive. We're at the end of the show. Did you have fun?
I survived, I think.
You survived?
I think I survived a second project. Yeah.
I hope you did more than just survive.
Actually, Pete taking me off as he has now for the last 12 months has been one of the best things that has ever happened to my popularity.
I will stop immediately.
Always. It's a bit bumpy sometimes.
Thank you so much for coming along and being
Absolutely.
Such a great sport. It's
Thank
been so good
much.
To have you back on the show.
Thank you.
Good morning, everybody.